Hey, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, RC1. Oh, hold on just one second. I want to make sure that what happened yesterday didn't happen again. Just finishing up a project from the other day. Ah, that's good. I think that plank will stay there. And I won't have to worry about falling in that hole again. Excellent. So back to the video today. Let's make a bat belt buckle out of essentially garbage for no cost or next to no cost. I just rigged up this new thing here for an overhead camera so you can see better what I'm actually doing. It's just an old defunct selfie pole stick that will allow me to have the camera where it needs to be to see what I'm doing here. And in this upcoming year, I'm hoping to do more do-it-yourself hands-on things that actually show you what I'm doing. There will also be other things. So this particular thing right now is going to be about building a bat belt buckle out of garbage. But the next one's going to be an economics talk. And I'm going to help you in the vein of Batman costuming with the economics talk, because that's been specially requested. But I'm also going to talk about other economic things that me as a starving artist has done all my life to live a decent life, and you can too, with some of the tips. So here we are. This video is going to be just about the bat belt buckle that you make out of garbage to complete this bat belt that I was working on the other day. It took me 6 months to fill from remnants of resin pourings to get enough buckles to do this belt. So it didn't really cost anything. I had the old leather from 20 years ago. I left this space. I thought, oh, the next person that has this can put a buckle on it. But no, I'm gonna go ahead and do one as an option for them. Because when I was jogging the other day, suddenly there, on the ground in front of me, because everybody throws everything out now, and a lot of people around here throw things out that's still good, but they just want the latest and greatest. So I just grabbed their old scraps, and I'm gonna show you how to make a belt buckle out of just a simple cell phone case. Garbage on the street. We have here a symbol. Now, this is actually a symbol. I think it's from OnStar. I've never really made a symbol from it. I don't make symbols. I don't offer things like that. But I flattened it out, and I want to fit it in here. And I want to make a belt buckle. And first thing I have to do is get rid of this flashing. I had one of these laying around. I can make these anytime I want. You don't have to make things out of molds if you don't want to. You can make things out of anything. Foamies, cardboard, plastic, anything, you can cut it in this shape. So for this tutorial, I will be using this, but I don't expect you to have to use that. So the first thing we see is that, like I said, there's some flashing around there. What I usually do is I go ahead and over pour, knowing that if my item is flat, I'm gonna go ahead and belt sand the back, okay? That helps me to loosen the flashing up, and I can pretty much just eliminate it, just as simply as that. Now, this is a mold that I had from a long time ago, maybe 20 years, and I've never used it. It's just a rough, it's labeled rough. It's a two-sided mold. It's actually supposed to be curved. What I did was, the same way I showed you about rounding the buckle in another video, on this one I actually flattened it while it was still setting up. I did this in anticipation to use this phone case. This is gonna be the back. This is gonna go in there like that, and this is gonna go over the top of it. So the first thing I'll do is to make sure that it's pretty much cleaned up. But everything's gonna be aged. Everything's gonna be aged like this belt. And it's all gonna look okay really fast. Because as we all know, the pie is split so many ways, we can't even really do anything unless we're doing it for ourselves without having to be fast. So I'll go ahead and I'll get rid of anything else that's not supposed to be there. And this is a rough, so this is not perfect. So knowing that, and knowing it's gonna be inside of this, I'm gonna go ahead and just give it a quick overall spray, and I'm actually gonna age it. There's some air bubbles in there, and I don't care. That's why it's a rough. It was gonna be an in-between step to do a better mold. That's why it's a rough. So do the same thing I've been showing you before from a different angle here, and I'm just gonna show you straight up how to do it. Basically just take, spritz it, get a little medium on there, you know. You watch Bill Alexander and Bob Ross videos, they always have the magic white on the canvas. Why? Because they want assistance in their blending. Same thing here. Now, any inconsistencies I have, I could build it up and get rid of those things. But for me, I want to make it be like, hey, this was a batarang and it's the door springs open. And I've used it a number of times on past missions and I've gone to retrieve it. But it's got a few scratches. Got a few, come on, where's the scratch? Give me a happy accident, ah. Sometimes you have to force, a happy accident. If it ain't cooperating, it's a round surface. Nah, it's not cooperating for me. Sometimes you have to force happy accidents. So I'm just gonna give it a little bit of a brush finished, making it look like it's been used a little bit. A lot of times what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll add some scrapes.
that are not part of the finish that you put on, but they're different scrapes. Just to give it a feel like, okay, this is beyond just the one medium I've used. It's into something else. And I'm gonna go ahead and maybe get them a little bit too much to the part where they start to offend me. I go, oh, I messed it up. I wanna make sure they offend me a little bit. I wanna go a little bit too far. See, that's more than I would have liked. Golly gee, how many times did he use this Batarang? And then what I do is just go ahead and sometimes I'll go over it with black. Dull it down just a little bit more. Make those scrapes a little bit less, even though they're there. And then come over it one more time in a few crucial areas. A lot of times what I'll do is I'll switch over to a Q-tip or something else. Whatever I feel it needs. But I've gotten it now to where my scrapes are there. And everything is acceptable as far as I'm concerned with being what's gonna go inside. We know this is the back, because that's a giveaway. Well, that's a cell phone case. Everything else on the belt is gold. This metallic gold is really, really good at covering stuff up. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray it with black first, just to give me a base so you can't see through it, okay? I always do with everything else. And then I'm just gonna put a little bit of yellow on there. Oh, look at that. Ooh, didn't expect it to be so messy. No problem though. This is one of the things I like about working with this. If you don't like what you've got, you change what you've got. I don't want to build it too much, because if I build it too much, it's going to want to peel away from that slick surface underneath. But I put the yellow on there knowing I was going to get a more opaque look for the gold. I wanted a little bit of yellow, but I didn't want to say I'm yellow, okay? So now I'm saying I've got yellow, but I'm not yellow. If you put it in comparison with the belt, should say, yeah, that's more yellow than the rest of the surrounding parts. That's enough of a yellow for a used aged belt like this. One of the most important things before I put the symbol in is to make sure that there's enough difference between them. And I think there is. Just enough to say, I'm here, but I'm not announcing my presence. I'm gonna go ahead and let this dry, I put it off to the side, and I'm gonna get this ready. This is the covering. I could have it just be clear, but it looks chunky. Batman doesn't use junky things, he uses good stuff because he's got the best, right? So what we want to do is we want to take it away from where it is and we want to make it so it's not junky, but it looks intentionally something else, okay? So the very first thing we're going to do is once again, use a little bit of black. Just enough to get a medium on there. Just enough around mostly on the edges. All right, then we're going to go and put some gold in. And our goal is to just make it look like it's not a cell case, but it's some kind of protective mechanism that springs open when he needs a Batarang fast. And it serves as his symbol before it springs open for a little while. Maybe there's another one that slides over behind it. I don't know. But we wanna take it far enough away from a cell phone case. We wanna make it look like it's a used thing that houses a 3D Batarang. Now, you don't have to use a 3D Batarang. Whatever you got, like I said, cut out cardboard, be fine, okay? You could take and mold something if you want, or make a little thing, whatever. But you don't have to do that. You have all kinds of resources available to you, and they're your own. Don't worry about what I'm doing. Do what you want to do. We're reaching the day and age where it's just not, it's not worthwhile anymore for people that provide people with things like this. It's just not worth it. You can have more fun using your imagination and making your own stuff. So I know that that's what I'm gonna have. I know that it's gonna go on here. It's not quite dry enough because I put more on than I wanted to. You can still see the spots, and I want to see the spots. Because if they're spots, that means that those little paint particles are only holding hands. They're not solid. And when there's a bend or a desire to peel away, that desire will be nipped in the bud because they're only holding hands and they'll go, okay, no problem, let go of you. Okay, no problem, let go of you. What people try to do when they're not used to using spray paint is they put it on so thick because it looks so beautiful and glossy when it's wet. And what happens is it shrinks and does different things. And the article underneath it does different things. And it wants to pull away at its first possible chance. One of the things I can tell you about spray paint is understand and realize this and work as if you know this. All right, so there's my housing. And when this is dry, my buckle's gonna be under there. Now, I'm not gonna glue it on right now, and I'm not gonna assemble the whole belt. I'm just gonna talk you through this. That is going to be what it is. Now, every time I see an old belt thrown away or whatever, I grab it. I had some pictures of this the other day. It wasn't mounted on there. Basically, take this wonderful Nautica belt that somebody probably paid 40 bucks for in the height of the Nautica phase. Now you get it for free. It's real leather, it buckles. You have your automatic sizing, okay? Simply glue this on here and you buckle it behind you instead of in front. You glue this on here, or Velcro if you wanna use Velcro more often, and that way you can change your buckle up if you use Velcro. And you have your finished belt, just as simple as that. Now, I don't have to have this space right here. I can cut this, overlap it, and glue it together. Or I can just say, okay, I want a little bit of differentiation. The reason this space is here is because the buckle I was originally gonna use was a little bit wider. If I wanna go and say, I don't wanna do that now, I can just spring it together, no problem. But I'm going to give the end user the ability to do that. So there we have it. That's how you put a buckle made out of junk. Well, this isn't junk. I mean, you'd have to have this in order to mold it. But I mean, made out of junk, pretend you made your own bat that you cut out of cardboard, okay? Just take that out of it. I work with this stuff all the time, so there's always options for me. And you're done. Just as simple as that. Like I say, it took me about 6 months to pour up 16 of these out of remnants of old cups. So this took me about, I guess, 3 months to have it be no cost. Lo and behold, something presents itself if you're always looking. And sometimes you have something, sometimes you don't. Do it your own way, all right? You can easily put something that's not sculpted or molded in there. You can do it like that and it'll be just as good. I mean, underneath here, the whole idea is it's a batarang that you can use. It springs open and out comes, boom, when you need it. That's the whole idea. You could do that yourself. Now, why am I telling you what you could do yourself if I'm a guy that could actually sell you something? Because there's more to life than just making money. And the next video. So why am I talking about these things? Look how easy that is. Tape, an old stick that doesn't work. Why am I telling you these things? Because life is more than money. Life is more than greed. Life is more than how can I push the other person down and pick myself up? Why am I talking about these things when I'm a maker? And I could easily just make this all about how can I get somebody to say, hey, take this, take this. You don't see links. You don't see promo advertisement. I don't talk about those things. Because if it isn't going to be real and it isn't going to come automatically, then I don't want it. I'm going to give an economics talk in the next video that's going to talk about this a little bit more. I gave away something the other day to a good buddy. He said, boy, what'd you do that for? There's a lot of good bat buddies out there that are worth it, okay? But I look and I measure up the certain circumstances to things. I don't tell everybody else what I'm doing. I shouldn't have to. The point is where I realize that giving is more important than taking. So that's one of the things I want this channel to be more about. But I have to be careful. And I want you to understand this one caveat. If I shoot my foot getting the pistol out of the holster, then I can't do anything. Because the ability of what I do that's separate doesn't allow me to have this freedom and flexibility. So really, I'd ask you to share. I'd ask you to be regulars. Because if I don't have this flexibility to stand here before you, then that'll be the end. And you know what the rest of the world is out there with the other makers and the way things are. Your whole world will be like that. My goal is to become something different. A symbol. Talking Batman here again. Something more. I've already done this in my regular life. I've already done this with my whole art mentality throughout my whole life. And now I want to make it more feasible, not with conscious counseling, but with a regular person in front of me to explain what this all means. So stay tuned for the economics talk. Don't skip the boring videos like that. I'll try to take them out of these crafting videos, but I'll still try to have them there so that if you realize there's something to who I am and what I do, that there's more to who I am and what I do, tune into those videos too. And remember, talk to me and I'll talk to you. I'm so small and I'm so straightforward. I can do that and I love to do that. In fact, it's one of the biggest things I get out of this. Just the ability to make it fun for me and for you and to relate. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy1. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies.